Recently, we have seen the release of several prominent set of guidelines for the management of hypertension around the world. It started in 2017 when the American guidelines were released, followed by the European guidelines in 2018, and those from the United Kingdom released in 2019. Also, the Japanese guidelines were released in 2019. One could easily ask why yet another set of hypertension guidelines are required at this stage. But let's look at this world map of age-standardized mean systolic blood pressures, showing low to high blood pressures from blue and purple to orange and red. It is quite striking to see that the countries that released guidelines recently are also the countries with the lowest blood pressures around the world. These are typically also clearly high-income regions. When looking at the rest of the global map, it is clear that those in green, yellow, and red, orange, are typically lower middle-income countries and regions that are less affluent and with lower resources available. These countries typically adopt the guidelines from higher-income countries since there's no resources or limited resources to develop own guidelines. Although this is often the only choice available, the global guidelines or the guidelines released from high-income countries are not necessarily fit for global purpose, as they rely on regions where there are availability of medication, great infrastructure, as well as a high volume of healthcare workers available to actually manage hypertension. And these are typically not the case in low-resource settings. It should also be taken into account that the global burden of hypertension is quite distorted, and that the high-income regions carry a much lower burden of the global prevalence of hypertension. Over 1 billion people with hypertension reside in low- and middle-income countries, typically the regions that have less resources to manage hypertension. So to address this discrepancy, and to align with the mission of the International Society of Hypertension, namely to reduce the global burden of raised blood pressure, we developed the ISH 2020 Global Hypertension Practice Guidelines for Adults. We extracted evidence-based content from recently published guidelines and tailored both essential and optimal standards of care. Essential standards of care refer to minimum standards, and every effort should be made to achieve essential standards of care in order to reduce the global burden of hypertension and deaths and disabilities based on hypertension. Optimal standards of care refer to evidence-based standards, and these are typically articulated in guidelines that were released recently. Throughout this presentation and throughout the guidelines, essential and optimal standards of care will be shown in these green and blue text in figures and tables throughout. So to take this together, the ISH 2020 Global Hypertension Practice Guidelines were thus developed based on evidence criteria to be used globally, to be fit for application in low-resource and high-resource settings by advising on essential and optimal standards of care, and to be concise, simplified, and easy to use by clinicians, nurses, and community health workers as appropriate.